Hi po, are you familiar with effective learning theory?
Hello po, are you familiar with Lev Vygotsky's concept of zone of proximal development?
Hi guys, are you familiar with John Schumann acculturation model theory?
Are you familiar with David Aicholz's experiential learning?
Hello guys, are you familiar with Stephen Krashen's monitor hypothesis theory?
Okay.
as well for Levi Vygotsky's concept of zone of proximal development. We all know that zone of proximal development is the distance between a learner's ability to learn with or without a mentor or interpreter. On this concept of constructivism, it is known that teachers and mentors help us to learn a language or perform a specific task. So that is why we work better with a more knowledgeable one, or with parents, teachers, and
some advantages, that's why it is in group or in by pair. So the advantages are it gives a sense of achievement to the students. It teaches them how to be and how to be led by others. And students may share their knowledge to each other. Aside from that, working with your friends or the one you're close
theory of behaviorism includes positive and negative reinforcement, where positive reinforcement strengthens the behavior by providing consequences to an individual, but defines it rewarding. That your teacher gave to you symbolizes or stands as your reward. It means that he or she wants you to strive more or to keep up your good work. When you are learning a language, this theory is one of the best for you to follow.
Okay. And to learn a language.
Yes, lollipops are the best.
I think Scott will do the next.
I have already found my dream. Of course, I
need a
book for that.
That is mine, thank you.
Of course, from Chao. Why is it important to participate in this initial class? So, school
science.
Yeah, oh, that's bad.
Are
you
try or
not?
You need that to get
Uno. But aside from getting Uno, what is other reasons for that?
Yeah. Aside from that, we all know that school participation is important. Action inside the classroom is not only for the teacher and the student, but all the whole classroom needs to be involved. Now based on a fluctuation theory of what we've learned in the past few years.
Again?
A fluctuation theory.
I remember.
Based on that, if one learner is, and if an individual learner is pressured, learning will be much easier. It's like when you are pressured, you become productive.
That's why I
since when you recite, you are in front of the class, right? Everyone is listening to you, the teacher and your peers inside the classroom. You feel pressured to perform better.
Why your teacher conducted an extemporaneous speech in your can be. So congratulations to all of us. We are now done with our blind box challenge. And as you can see, we all have our food. And I think we deserve it because we are all hungry.
But wait, guys. Have you observed that all of us are wearing red?
Ah, yes.
Do you know why?
Because red is the color that can easily catch attention of our students, especially you, viewers.
Aside from that, the colors blue and green are also can also be used because it is very soothing and fun.
Yeah.
So thank you for accompanying us on this episode of Principles and Theories regarding the English language learning.
Oh, and please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share our page.
And yes, and if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to send us a DM on our social media channel. And again, we're on another episode of
Sabantay!